Today we are going to cover a topic about wire fraud, as we are faced with that every single day as those wires come and go from buyers into title companies. And this is a topic that we thought that we needed to go over sooner than later. So Lisa's going to take it from here.
Yeah, wire fraud is getting more and more popular, and we are seeing it. The title companies talk about it all the time. So we want to make sure it doesn't happen to you. All you watching, if you're planning on buying a house here in the near future, or you've already bought one, you are probably already told this, and especially by us. So after you go under contract, you are going to be doing two, possibly three wires, depending on how many escrow or good faith deposits you're putting in. Right after execution, you have a few days to get your good faith deposit in. That goes into the title company. So you can either take in a personal check, or you can wire your money into the title company account. So the way that happens is the title company is going to send you an email with the wiring instructions. Sometimes realtors send it out. We prefer title companies send directly to our clients so that it comes straight from them. They can send out secure emails. However, emails are getting hacked. And the way that happens is the hacker gets into the email, changes the account numbers to their account, and then your wire goes to their account. We don't want that happening to any of our buyers or anybody out there. So this is what you need to do. You need to, as soon as you get those wiring instructions, you call up the title company, make sure you have the number, and before you wire, you go through each one of those numbers and just verify what is in your email is the correct number.
Both routing and account number.
Mm-hmm. And then you go into your bank, don't do your wire online, go into your bank, and you will give the instructions either to the bank teller or, you know, just give them the account number, and they will wire your funds into that account. Now, recently, one of our buyers recently, they knew all about this. They were way too aware because it happened, the wire fraud actually happened to their parents. So they were buying a house a few months ago. Parents couldn't get a hold of their realtor at the time. And what happened is they ended up getting an email that looked like it was from their realtor. And it gave them all the wiring instructions and what to do that day.
On letterhead and everything.
Yeah, the letterhead was like the title company letterhead. And so they went ahead and did their wire. And then the title company said they never got the wire. Well, come to find out, it was a fake email. They lost their money. It did not make it to the title company. They never got it back, did not end up getting that house. So they knew when I told them, they said, oh, we know all about this. We are very much aware. But we want everyone to be aware, all our buyers,
and anyone
very important. Anyone out there, yes. Mm-hmm. We don't want you to lose your money. Mm-hmm. You are going to be doing a second wire, or maybe your third wire, at the end of the transaction, but right before you close, you have to send and do a wire of all your closing funds. That is going to be, even though you had the wire instructions before, you're going to have those wire instructions again. Go and verify those numbers. Give the title company a call right before you go do that wire, because that is a large amount usually, and you want to close on your house that day. So take those instructions and pay attention, because there's a lot more of this.
Is it the bird flying back?
We have a guest. There's a lot of this going on. We hear about it on a daily basis. So we want you just to take every precaution possible so that you don't lose out on your wiring funds.
Yeah, one other thing. When you do wire, you know, Lisa mentioned in regards to the wire and going into your bank, there's a federal wire which is going into your bank, and then there's another thing where you can go online where you can do a wire, but it's actually an ACH deposit, and that is not the same, and the title companies will not accept that. The ACH is where you do something through Zelle, D-E-L-L-E, and that's not the same. That actually takes several days for the title company to receive that and will not be accepted. Another thing, now, if you're working with like a stockbroker and you're moving from IRA funds, that is a completely different wire. That you can work out with over the phone, because that is done in a completely different way, and that is a federal wire. So don't be, you know, feel free to talk to us about it or talk to your realtor about it, of what the difference is, and make sure that you're doing that wire the right way.
That's very important.
Yes.
Because you could lose out on a house if you don't get your escrow in time. And if you go online and do it, it could cause some issues if it's not done correctly.
Yes.